if an ad is very high at lost impression share, IS means impression share rank, what could we do to improve it? So what this gentleman or lady is asking is, if I'm losing my impression share due to the ad rank, what can you do to improve it? I'll just put this in so it's easier for everybody. Impression share. So what you want to do is, you want your impression share to be as high as possible, right? So you don't want to be losing out, but there's lots of ways we can help improve it. So let's have a look at it. So first of all, what I would highly recommend is you organize your ad groups properly. You know, they need to be highly themed. So don't have Apple iPhone and Samsung phones in the same ad group. Keep them separate. If you are running a service-based business, then yes, absolutely, keep them separate. The theme needs to be very tight, because nowadays Google's keyword match types are not exact. Is not exact. Phrase match is not phrase match anymore. They show for close variants. So you want to control this and keep it as tight as possible. That will help. That will help Google understand what you're trying to sell. You want high CTR on your ads. That means that ideally you want to be above 2% on non-branded keywords. So what I mean by that? The branded keyword would be Nike, Puma, iPhone, and so on, right? And non-branded would be by smartphones of smartphone, cheap or something like that. Then we have what was the other one? iPhone, yeah, smartphone, Nike, Puma, so buy running shoes. That is non-branded. Yeah. Buy jogging t-shirt. So somebody is looking to buy these items. So for non-branded, you want those CTR or the click-through rate to be above 2%. If it's below 2%, have a look at the keywords and have a look at your ad and see if there is relevancy between the two. You've got to have those relevancy and what we call ad scent on there. Keyword must be on the ad, so you have higher ad relevance. That is important. Ideally in H1, headline one, right? First thing they say, if I'm looking to buy a Nike running shoes, then your headline one should be buy Nike running shoes. Put in a price as well, because the price is going to qualify or disqualify that click. So if you are selling that Nike shoes for, let's say, $50, then most people will say, I can afford $50. I'm going to click on this ad and see which shoes they are selling. But if you got some gold-plated Nike shoes and you put in $500, many will not even click on it because it's out of their price range. And then you do not waste your budget on irrelevant clicks, because all they're going to do is come onto your website, click on the ad, come to the website or landing page. You're going to have a look around and then they'll go away. So keyword must be on the ad. The next one, improve landing page experience to increase your quality score. And what I mean by improving the landing page experience is the page speed, That is one of the most important factors, especially for e-commerce websites and for lead generation as well. You've got to have a fast landing page or a website. If your landing website page speed is 6 seconds or 7 seconds, that's too slow. You've got to be under 3, ideally under 2 seconds. So that is really important and critical. Facebook, Google, all of them, they look at it and then they will decide whether you have got a high enough quality score or not. Then you use ad extensions, put in the call if you want to put showcase your phone or the location if you've got a shop and you want to showcase your location. So use ad extensions and site links as much as possible. The other important bit is bid aggressively and high. Don't be scared of increasing your bids, right? If my cost per conversion is, let's say, $20, don't be scared to bid $40 and tell Google, hey, I'm prepared to pay you $40 to get a lead or a sale. It does not mean that Google is going to charge you $40 for that lead or sale. What it means is that you are going to beat the majority of your competitors in that ad auction. Most of them will not have the guts to do that, right? They are saying, okay, I want $20 leads or a sale. Bid aggressively and see what happens. And you will start to get more impression share and your ads will be seen a lot more. Also, if you don't have this column in your dashboard, which is the impression absolute top percentage and the impression top percent. So let's go into our Google Ads and I'll show you how. So this is your dashboard, right? You've got all these options over here. All you do is you go into your columns and then, where is it gone? Competitive metrics. No, not there. Where is it gone? It's disappeared. It was here somewhere. I think it's because it's showing me that video campaigns. That's why it's somewhere here. It used to be under competitive metrics. Not there. All right, I'm not going to waste a bit more. I think there is a bit of a glitch on here. Usually it is in the competitive metrics. So how competitive you are. And for some reason, it's not showing me in this account for the time being. Where is my competitive? I'll just move this for you. So it's usually under there. See, it's showing me the display one, that's why. Display impression share, display lost IS rank, display lost. So it's only showing me the display one. I think it's this account has only got the display ones for the time being. So that's why it is. Or it could be a glitch in Google Ads. But go under competitive metrics and to go in here, you just click on the columns and you will see all of these. You can save your column sets and go to competitive metrics. That's where you will change it. And you'll be able to see it. And what you want to do is you want your impression share to be as close to 100 as possible. You pretty much won't get it, but ideally you want to be above 100% or 80%. Can't go more than 100. Okay, so I hope that helped. All right.